Department of Homeland Security that they reside within the United States during the period required by law. They've also shown that during such period, they have been, still are, persons of good moral character attached to the principles of the Constitution and well disposed to the good order and happiness of the United States of America. On the basis of our concluding investigations, I move that you accept the oath of allegiance and grant the United States.
All right, thank you. I will grant that motion and I will administer the oath at this time. At the conclusion of the oath, I'll have a couple of remarks to make. So at this time, I'll ask all of you, all of the citizens, to please rise and repeat after me. Put your right hand to repeat after me. I hereby declare on oath that I absolutely and entirely renounce and abjure all allegiance and fidelity to any foreign prince,
potentate,
state or sovereignty, of whom or which
I have heretofore
been a subject or citizen, that I will support and defend the Constitution and laws of the United States of America against all enemies,
foreign and domestic,
that I will bear true faith
and
allegiance to the same, that I will bear arms
on behalf of the United States
when required by the law, that I will perform non-combatant service in the armed forces of the United States when required by the law, that I will perform work of national importance
under civilian direction
when required by the law, and that I take this obligation freely without any mental reservation or purpose of evasion. So help me God.
So help me God.
This is a very happy time for the court. It's a very happy time for me. I look back on my mother's parents came from Ireland. My father's parents came from Italy. They came with, maybe they had family in the United States and maybe not. One side did and the other side not so much. They came with very little and they did so happily. And I look back on the courage that they had to do that, to make that big change. It's been a source of strength for me. That said, there are a couple aspects about being a new citizen that I want to just describe to you. Of course, you've been told about your right to vote, and I think Ms. Van Ryan here, the League of Women Voters are available to register you to be able to vote. And they're here to facilitate that. And so you should. I would encourage you to learn about the things that are going to be on the ballots that you can make a decision about, learn about them, and then make the effort. Sometimes it's convenient, sometimes it's not so convenient, but you know, this is obviously a very important part of our democracy is having your say, participating in the elections by voting. So I encourage you to do that. The other aspect of being a new citizen is helping to decide disputes in our society. Many years ago in England, where we take the United States of America takes its legal roots, people were called or ordered to come to court or to gather together to make decisions in the community. And that has evolved over many, many years, perhaps 1,000 years, and it was adopted in the United States with the new colonies, and it continues today. We have the right to be tried before a jury in a criminal case sometimes and in a civil case sometimes. It's not like most of the rest of the world where professional judges make decisions on all such cases in many parts. There are a lot of places where jury trials are conducted. But you may get a summons. It's not an invitation to a party. Come if it's convenient. It is a court order. There are qualifications for being a juror or not. And if you have excuses, there are excuses that can be used. But I would look upon, if I were you, I would look upon that opportunity as an important facet of our democracy, where citizens are brought from the community to sit with a judge. But the jury, as we know, is an independent entity and will make a decision on the facts of the case that then the judge adopts and makes a ruling about the outcome of the case. And it can be a minor case, it can be an auto accident, it can be a very important case involving the government, it can be an important case involving big corporations, and jurors still are asked to come in from the community to make a decision. So, if you do get a jury summons for either a state court or the federal court, I ask you to look on it as an important part of your being a citizen. And I think most of the time it's a very interesting thing to do. All right, all of that being said, again, congratulations on becoming a new citizen of the United States. At this time, I'll ask Ms. Van Ryan, our deputy clerk, to lead us in the Pledge of Allegiance. So everybody, please rise.
Your name forward, and your family is welcome to come up and take some photos of